Hello everyone, welcome back to Chenda DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a mini tulip pot. It is perfect as a gift for your friend or family. For this mini tulip pot pattern, it is really easy, friendly for beginners. Okay, now let's get into the video. First thing first, we are going to make the pot. To begin, make a magic circle. And next, we are going to make single crochet. For row 1, make single crochet into the circle. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the circle, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first single crochet stitch. It is where we are going to make slip stitch at the end of the row. Keep making single crochet into the circle until you got 6 stitches of single crochet, then I will meet you back again. After you got 6 stitches of single crochet, then pull the short string of yarn tight to close the circle. And next, we are going to make slip stitch into the stitch that we mark. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. After you have made slip stitch, next for row 2, chain 1. For chain 1, we don't count as a stitch. Next, we are going to make increase by make 2 single crochet into the same loop near chain 1. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at the first single crochet stitch. After you got 2 stitches in the same loop, then we are going to repeat the same thing by make 2 single crochet in the same loop into each stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, you must have 12 stitches in total. For the small loop that near chain 1, it then count as a stitch, so then make single crochet into that stitch. And then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the stitch that we mark. Next, for row 3, chain 1 and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. Next, we are going to make increase into the next stitch by make 2 single crochet in the same loop. After you have made increase, then we are going to repeat the same thing by make single crochet in the next stitch and then make increase. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row, then we meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, you must end with increasing stitch. And next, we are going to continue make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. After you have made slip stitch, next, for row 4, chain 1, and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. And then make another single crochet into the next stitch. After you got 2 single crochets, and then we are going to make increase into the next stitch by make 2 single crochet in the same loop. After you have made increase, then we are going to repeat the same thing by make 2 single crochets. And then make increase until you reach the end of the row, then we meet you back again. Like I said, at the end of the row, you must end with increasing stitch. Then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Next, for row 5, chain 1 and make single crochet into the next 3 stitches. After you got 3 single crochets, then we are going to make increase. After you have made increase, then we are going to repeat the same thing by make 3 single crochets and then increase until you reach the end of the row, then we meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. You have to stretch it a little bit to give a nice and flat circle. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 5. And next, we are going to use this pot base to place on the cardboard. You can use a pen to draw around the circle and cut it. Next, continue from where your last stitch is, for row 6, chain 1. Then we are going to make single crochet but into the back loop of the stitch only. Single crochet back loop only into the stitch near chain 1. Keep making single crochet back loop only into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then we meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, like I said, for the small loop that near chain 1 we don't count as a stitch, then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. After you have made slip stitch, next for row 7 and row 8, chain 1 and make single crochet into each stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. So start from row 7, we are going to make single crochet into both loop. And now you must have 3 rows of normal single crochet, no increase. Next, for row 9, chain 1. And make single crochet into the next 7 stitches, then we meet you back again. After you got 7 stitches of single crochet, then we are going to make increase into the next stitch. After you have made increase, then we are going to repeat the same thing by make 7 single crochet and then increase until you reach the end of the row, then we meet you back again. For this last increase in stitch, I make 5 single crochet and then increase into the last stitch of the row. After you have made increase, then continue make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Next, for row 10, chain 1 and make single crochet into each stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. After you have made slip stitch, next, for row 11, chain 1 and make single crochet into the next 10 stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you got 10 stitches of single crochet, then we are going to make increase into the next stitch. After you have made increase, then we are going to repeat the same thing by make 10 single crochet and then increase until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Next, for row 12, chain 1 and make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row, then make slip stitch. After you have made slip stitch, for row 13, chain 1 and make single crochet into the next 13 stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you got 13 stitches of single crochet, then we are going to make increase into the next stitch. After you have made increase, then we are going to repeat the same thing by make 13 single crochet and then increase until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Next, for row 14 until row 16, chain 1 and make single crochet into each stitch around until you reach the end of the row and make slip stitch. Then I will meet you back again. After you have made 3 rows of normal single crochet, no increase. And now you must have 11 rows for the side of the pot. Next, for row 17, chain 3. Turn your work. Then we are going to make double crochet back loop only. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the back loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Keep making double crochet back loop only into each stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then we meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, next we are going to make slip stitch into the first double crochet stitch, not into the chain 3 stitch. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Flip double crochet row inside out like this. And now the pot is done. Next, we are going to make the cover for the pot. For the cover of the pot, we repeat the same thing like the pot base. Make a magic circle and make 6 single crochet into the circle and then keep increasing until you got 5 rows. After you got 5 rows like the pot base, then we are going to add 1 more row. Continue from where your last stitch is. For row 6, chain 1 and make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. After you got 4 stitches of single crochet, then make increase into the next stitch. After you have made increase, then we are going to repeat the same thing by make 4 single crochet and then increase. Repeat this until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. After you have made slip stitch, then chain 1 and leave a long tail of yarn it keep for sewing and cut it off. Next, we are going to sewing the cover of the pot into the pot. So I'm going to skip the first row and insert the needle into the second row, as you can see. Keep sewing it around, but don't close it yet. You have to keep some space. And next, we are going to make tulip flower. To begin, make a magic circle. And then make 6 single crochet into the circle. After you got 6 single crochet, then pull the short string of yarn tight to close the circle. And next, we are going to continue make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 1 and make increase into each stitch around until the end of the row, then we meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, you must have 12 stitches of single crochet, and then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Next, for row 3, chain 1 and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. After you have made single crochet, then make increase. After you have made increase, then we are going to repeat the same thing by make one single crochet and then increase until you reach the end of the row, then we meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, you must end with increasing stitch. And next, you don't have to make slip stitch to connect the row. For the next row, start from row 4 until row 9. Just continue make single crochet into the first single crochet of row 3. And then don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at the single crochet stitch. It is easy to know where to start the new row. Keep making single crochet into each stitch around until you reach row 9, then we meet you back again. So start from row 4 without make increase, just make normal single crochet stitch around. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 9. In total, you must have 9 rows. And then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the stitch that we mark. After you have made slip stitch, then leave a long tail of yarn, it keep for sewing, and cut it off. Then cut the wire for 12 inches and fold it into two pieces like this. We use it as a stem of the tulip. Adding the toy stuffing as much as you can to make the tulip look fluffy. Next, fold this into two pieces like this. Then insert the needle into both middle part. And then fold the opposite side, and then insert the needle into the middle part of it. Next, we are going to make the leaves. To begin, make a slip knot. And then make 13 chains. After you got 13 chains, next for row 1, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into the next chain. And then bring the wire that we cut for 7 inches and fold it in half like this. And we are going to make single crochet and carrying this along with the row by place the wire on top of the yarn. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And now as you can see, the wire is inside the stitch. Next, we are going to make half double crochet into the next chain. To make half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, and then place the wire on top of the hook, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Keep making half double crochet into every chain until you have 2 last chain, then we meet you back again. Thank you. After you have two last chain, then we are going to make single crochet. After you have made a single crochet, for the last chain, we are going to make increase by make 3 single crochet in the same loop. After you got 3 single crochet in the same loop, then pull this increasing stitch onto the top of the wire. And next, we are going to make the other side of the leaves. To begin, make single crochet with the other side stitch. Make sure that the wire and this tail of yarn is on top of the hook. We are going to carry them along with the row. After you have made a single crochet, and then make half double crochet into each stitch until you have one last stitch, then I will meet you back again. After you have one last stitch, then we are going to make single crochet. After you have made a single crochet, then continue make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch of the other side. After you have made a slip stitch, then make another slip stitch and cut off the yarn. And now we are done for the leaves. Don't forget to repeat the same thing to the other leaf. Next, we are going to attach the leaves with the stem. To begin, you have to attach the green yarn into the bottom of the tulip. And then leave both strings long enough. It keeps for wrap around the stem, which is the wire. Then cut it off. Next, wrap the yarn around the wire. Make sure that you wrap it really tight. Next, we are going to insert the wire into the middle part of the pot. And when the wire gets inside the pot, and then stretch the wire to secure it. Next, we are going to continue sewing the cover of the pot to close it. And now we are done attaching the flower into the pot. Next, we are going to sewing smile emoji on the pot. Skip one row and insert the needle into the second row at the row below. And then count 2 stitches at the front and insert the needle into the middle part of these 2 rows. Count 5 stitches and insert the needle into the 5th stitch at the row above. Then skip 1 row and insert the needle into the 2nd row at the row below. Count 2 stitches and insert the needle into the middle part of both rows. Thank you. the mini tulip pot is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.